In this video, we will discuss addition rule and multiplication rule of probability. To better understand these concepts, let's go over some definitions. In the previous video, we discussed the probability of the events that are categorized as simple events. Now we will look at compound events, events that combine two or more outcomes. Events are considered disjoint, or they're also called mutually exclusive, if they can never occur at the same time. The events are not disjoint if they can occur at the same time and have some overlap. Now look at the following examples and try to determine whether the events are disjoint or not disjoint. Getting an odd number when rolling a dice and getting a 10 when rolling a dice. Right, this event is disjoint because dice has only 6 numbers and getting 10 is impossible. Randomly drawing a card from a deck of cards and getting a king. Randomly drawing a card from a deck of cards and getting a hearts. This is the example of not disjoint event, because we can get a card that is king of hearts. Complement of events are events that are mutually exclusive. They complement each other. We use A bar to indicate that event A does not occur. Event A bar is called complementary of event A. Because there are disjoint events, we can use the addition rule. Probability of A or A bar is equal to probability of event A plus probability of event A bar, which is equal to 1, because event either occurs or does not. Probability of a complement of event equal to 1 minus probability of event. And vice versa, probability of event A is equal 1 minus the complementary event. To better understand the concept of complementary events, let's look at the following example. What is the probability that when we randomly choose a person, their birthday is on Monday? How many Mondays in a week? 1 out of 7 days. What is the probability that when we randomly choose a person, their birthday is not on Monday? 6 out of 7. The rest of the days. The event will consider 1 out of 7 plus the complementary event, 6 out of 7, is equal to 7 out of 7 days, or 1 week. We are now ready to learn about the addition rule. The notation for addition rule is OR. Probability of event A or B is equal to probability that in a single trial, event A occurs or event B occurs, or they both occur. The formula to find the probability of event A or B is probability of event A plus probability of event B minus the overlap probability where event A and B occur at the same time. Or in mathematical terms, probability of the union of event A and B is equal probability of event A plus probability of event B minus the intersection of event A and B. A lot of companies nowadays require that a job applicant takes a drug test. Drug tests are not perfect and have some percent of inaccuracy in results. Wrong results can occur when a subject uses drugs and tests negative, it's called false negative, or does not use drugs but tests positive, it's called false positive. The following table includes the results from 1,000 adults. If one of the 1,000 subjects is randomly selected, find the probability of selecting a subject who has a positive test result or a person uses drugs. Probability that we select someone who has positive test result or subject uses drugs is equal to probability selecting someone with positive test result plus the probability of selecting someone who uses drugs minus the overlap, someone who has positive test result and using drugs. Probability of selecting someone with positive test result is 134 over 1,000 total, plus the probability of selecting someone who uses drugs is 44 plus 6, 50 out of 1,000, minus the overlap, someone who has positive test result and using drugs. Let's see, where is the overlap? Right here, positive test result and using drugs, 44 out of 1,000. Let's calculate. It's fraction, so we can put it under one denominator. and add 134 plus 50 minus 44 is equal to 140 over 1000 or 0.140. Or if you want to write it as percentage, it will be 14%. Two events are considered independent if the occurrence of one does not affect the probability of the occurrence of the other event. Several events are independent if the occurrence of any does not affect the probability of the occurrence of the others. If event A and B are not independent, they're said to be dependent. Let's look at the example with the cards.
What do you think is the probability that when I randomly select two cards from a deck of cards, I will get both of them hearts? Well, there are four suits in a deck of cards. Clubs, hearts, diamonds, and spades. And there are 52 cards. 52 divided by 4 will make it 13 of each suit. So I have 13 hearts out of 52. So the first time I pick the card, it will be 13 out of 52 that it is hearts. Now I'm going to pick the card, not going to look what it is, and put it aside. Now what's the probability that I will pick hearts? How many cards are there? Now there's only 51 left. And I don't know, maybe that card is hearts. So now I have 12 hearts. So now my probability that on the second time I pick hearts is 12 out of 51. These two events are called dependent because the outcome of the second event depend on the outcome of the first event. Now, if I choose the first card and then I put it back, then the probability that the second card will be hearts is still 13 out of 52 because I put that card back. These two events will be considered independent.
We will now learn about multiplication rule of probability. Multiplication is notated as AND in statistics, and probability of event A and event B is equal to probability of event A occurs in the first trial and event B occurs in the second trial. P of B, vertical line A, represents the probability of event A occurring after it is assuming that event A has already occurred. Probability of event A and B is equal P of A multiplied by probability of B, given that event A already occurred. Now let's look at the example. What is the probability that when I randomly pick two cards from a deck of cards without replacement, I do not put the first card back? Both of them are hearts. Probability that the first card is hearts and the second card is hearts is equal to probability of the first card being hearts times the probability the second card being hearts, given that the first one is hearts. Probability that the first card is hearts is 13 out of 52 because there are 13 hearts in a deck of cards and 52 total cards times, now when I pick the second card, I already have 12 hearts left and 51 total cards. Let's simplify this expression. Multiply numerators, denominators, divide. The answer is 0.0588235 and so on. It's repeating decimal. Remember, probability is rounded to three significant digits, 0.0588. Now let's look at the second part of this example. What is the probability that when I randomly pick two cards from a deck of cards with replacement, I'm going to put the first card back? Both of them are hearts. The probability that the first card is hearts is 13 out of 52 times the probability the second card is hearts is also 13 out of 52 because I put that card back. Simplifying this expression will give us 0.0625. In statistics, it is very important to choose the sampling method. When sampling with replacement, the selections are considered independent events. When sampling without replacement, the selections are considered dependent events.
However, there is an exception. when sampling without replacement and the sample size is no more than 5% of the size of the population, we treat the selections as being independent, even though they're actually dependent. For example, assume that 3 adults are randomly selected without replacement from the 247,436,830 adults in the United States. Also assume that 10% of adults in the United States use drugs. Find the probability that the 3 selected adults all use drugs. So we're looking for probability that the first subject uses drugs, and second subject uses drugs, and third subject uses drugs, and is translated as multiplication in statistics. So we multiply the probability of the first randomly selected adult uses drugs times probability that the second randomly selected adult using drugs multiplied by the probability that the third randomly selected adult uses drugs. Because the 3 adults are randomly selected without replacement, the 3 events are dependent. But here we treat them as being independent by applying the 5% guideline for cumbersome calculations. Because the sample size of 3 is clearly no more than 5% of the population size of 247,436,830. We multiply 0.1, 10% as a decimal, times 0.1 times 0.1 is equal 0.001. The probability that when we randomly select 3 adults, all 3 of them use drugs. The principle of redundancy is used to increase the reliability of many systems. Our eyes have passive redundancy in the sense that if one of them fails, we continue to see. An important finding of modern biology is that genes in an organism can often work in place of each other. Engineers often design redundant components so that the whole system will not fail because of the failure of a single component. For this example, we will assume that for a typical flight, the probability of a hydraulic system failure is 0.002. Part A. If the Airbus 310 were to have one hydraulic system, what is the probability that the aircraft's flight control would work for a flight? Probability that the system does not fail is equal 1 minus probability that system fails. They're complementary events. 1 minus P of A. 1 minus 0.002 is equal 0.998, or 99.8% that the system will not fail with one hydraulic system. Given that Airbus 310 actually has 3 independent hydraulic systems, let's find probability that on a typical flight, control can be maintained with a working hydraulic system. Probability of first system fails and second system fails and third system fails is equal to 0.002 times 0.002 times 0.002 is equal 0.00000008. So the probability that all 3 systems will not fail at the same time is equal 1 minus 0.00000008, which is equal to 0.99999992, close to 100%, that all 3 systems will not fail at the same time. In summary, addition rule is denoted as P of A or B. The word or suggests addition. And when adding probability of A and probability of B, we must add in such a way that every outcome is counted only once. Subtract the overlap. Multiplication rule is denoted as P of A and B. The word and for 2 trials suggests multiplication. And when multiplying P of A and P of B, we must be sure that the probability of event B taken into account the previous occurrence of event A. Coming up next, Chapter 4.3, Conditional Probability. Stay tuned.